Good morning, students. Today we'll discuss the NCERT problems. So this is the NCERT problem, element 1.1. So let us solve this problem. In the given problem, the problem is like this: obtain the binding energy in mega electron volt of nitrogen nucleus, given that the mass of the nitrogen nucleus is 14.00 3.7. Right? I mean, here nitrogen nucleus is given. We need to calculate binding energy. Already we have learned about the binding energy. What it is? The amount of energy required to separate the nucleons from the nucleus. That we are calling binding energy. See here. To remove the protons and neutrons from the nitrogen nucleus, we need to calculate the energy. So, first of all, we have to write what are the given values here. The given values are, actually the nitrogen nucleus is given, its mass can be given. The mass of the nitrogen nucleus. Mass of the nitrogen nucleus. How much it is? 14.00 3.74 into U, where U is nothing but atomic mass. Right? And we know that the mass of proton. Mass of proton. What is the mass of proton? Mass of proton is 1.007825 U, where U is atomic mass unit. And we know mass of neutron. Mass of neutron. Mass of neutron is 1.008665 U. 8665 U. And here atomic number is given for the given nucleus. How much atomic number is available? Z equal to 7 is available. And number of neutrons are given. Number of neutrons will be 14 minus 7. How much it is 14 minus 7? 8 minus 8, that comes to 7. What we need? We need to calculate the binding energy of this nucleus. Binding energy of this nucleus. Students, we know expression for binding energy. Expression for binding energy is nothing but ZLP plus A minus Z into M minus of capital M. Minus of capital M into C square. Right? Here, mass is in terms of kg. Mass is in terms of kg. And C represents speed of the light. And this value we are calling mass effect. Generally, how to write this value? E equal to how much? E equal to del M into C square. Del M into C square. Here, del M represents mass effect in terms of kg. But in terms of atomic mass unit, this binding energy can be written. In terms of atomic mass unit, binding energy can be written, that is del m into 1 amu. In terms of atomic mass unit, this binding energy formula can be modified, that is del m into 1 amu. We know that 1 amu value. What is 1 amu? 1 amu equal to 931 mega electron volt. Nearly 131 mega electron. By using this del M and by using this 1 amu, we can calculate binding energy. So let us solve. Let us solve. Shall I call this what? Equation number 1? Write out. First of all, calculate the mass effect of this value. What is del M? ZLP plus A minus Z into M minus capital A. Z represent number of protons, ZLP represent mass of the proton. A minus Z represent number of neutrons, M and represent mass of neutron, and capital A represent actual mass of the nucleus, that already given this value. Right? Now see here, students, in this problem, what do we have? And how to calculate energy? See here, first of all, let us calculate mass effect. Mass effect. What is the mass effect? ZMP plus a minus head into mn minus of capital M, right? So put all these values that we get. Z mp is how much? Z means how much? Certain number of protons are present. What is mp? Mass of the proton 1.007825 plus a minus z. How much a minus z? 7 number of neutrons are present. 7 number of neutrons are present. What is mass of neutron? Mass of neutron is what? 1.008652 I am capital M. What is capital M? 14.003074. 14.003074. This is what actual mass of the nucleus. Actual mass of nucleus. If we calculate all these values, we will get the mass effect. The mass effect is of the order 0.11236. What value? 0.11236. See here. Del M equal to 0.11236 U. U is nothing but atomic mass effect. So now you get the mass effect of this nucleus. Let us calculate the binding energy now from equation 1. E is equal to del M into 1 AMU. So put del M here, 91 M is nothing but 931 mega electron volt. So how to calculate from this? See here. How to calculate? E equal to del M. Del M how much? 0.1123 U. And 1 AMU is nothing but how much? 931 mega electron volt. 931 mega electron volt. So if we simplify this value will be 104.60. How much it is? 104.60 mega electron volt. This is what binding energy of a given nucleus nitrogen. But if we need binding energy per nucleon, what we need? Binding energy per nucleon. How to calculate binding energy? Binding energy per nucleon is binding energy divided by mass number. How much binding energy got? 104.60. 104.60 divided by mass number. How much mass number? 14 is the mass number. Then what is the binding energy per nucleon? Binding energy per nucleon is 14.9. Binding energy per nucleon is 14.9 mega electron volt. So from the given nitrogen nucleus, binding energy is 104.60 mega electron volt and binding energy per nucleon is 14.9 mega electron volt. So this is what in the given problem nitrogen nucleus is given. We calculated binding energy of the nitrogen nucleus. So let us see this problem for 2 seconds. We will start the next problem. Next numerical is binding energy in mega electron volt of the nuclei around ionization from following data. Following data means the mass of the ion is given and mass of the distance is given. We need to calculate binding energy of ion and binding energy of distance separately here. We know that separate calculation we need to calculate here. First of all, given that the mass of the proton already known in terms of U and mass of the neutron in terms of U. See here, in first case, we will see binding energy of ion. Binding energy of ion. Binding energy of ion. Later on. See here, for this ion, how many number of protons are present? 26 number of protons are present. That is atomic number. Then how to calculate number of neutrons? Number of neutrons equal to A minus Z. A
A minus I, 56 minus 26, how much? That is it. Right? We know that binding energy in terms of atomic mass in it. In terms of atomic mass in it, binding energy is given. What is binding energy? Binding energy is equal to Z into MP plus A minus Z into MN minus capital N into 1U or 1AMU. 1AMU. We know that 1AMU value. How much 1AMU? That equal to 931 mega electron volt. 931 mega electron volt. We know that the mass of the atomic mass of the iron and number of neutrons of the iron. And AMU and actual mass of the nucleus is given for iron. How much it is given? 55.93 4939. We're taking all these values, shall I calculate? See here. The binding energy. Binding energy of the iron. Z. What is Z? Z is nothing but the number of protons. 26. Mass of the proton. 1.007825 plus A minus Z. A minus Z is number of neutrons. 30. Mass of the neutron 1.008665 minus actual mass of the iron capital F. How much it is? 55.9349 of U. See what? Mass effect. And AMU, what is AMU? 1 AMU, how much it is? 931 mega electron volt. 931 mega electron volt. See here, 26 into 1.007825 plus 30 into 1.008665 minus this value. That is mass effect. How much mass effect will get? The mass effect of the order 0.5284. How much it is? Mass effect. Mass effect. How much it is mass effect? 0.5284461. This side. This side mass effect. Right? Into 1 AMU. 1 AMU is nothing but 931 mega electron volt. 931 mega electron volt. So, by calculating this value, we need the binding energy. The binding energy is 492.26. Binding energy of the iron is 492.26 mega electron volt. But we need binding energy per nucleon. This also is for the calculation. If we need binding energy per nucleon, binding energy per nucleon. How to calculate binding energy per nucleon? Binding energy per nucleon is binding energy divided by mass number. What is mass number? Mass number is 56 for the iron. Then how much it is? 492.26 divided by. How much? That is 56 equal to how much this value? This value is 8.79 mega electron volt. That's right. The binding energy per nucleon for iron in this model. How much it is? 8.79 mega electron volt. This is for iron. What it is? Binding energy for this iron. But here one more nuclei is here. What nuclei? Binding energy of bismuth. Binding energy of bismuth. Look at here. How to calculate binding energy of this bismuth? Again, we know that here bismuth nucleus is given. Bismuth nucleus is given. For this bismuth nucleus, atomic number is given and number of neutrons are given. How to calculate this value? This value can be calculated. So, by taking actual mass of this nucleus, actual mass of the nucleus. See here, bismuth. For this bismuth, how much atomic number is available? Atomic number. Atomic number is how much? That is what value? 83. And what about the mass number? The mass
209. Mass number is 209. So then number of neutrons can be calculated. So number of neutrons can be calculated by A minus Z. A minus Z, 209 minus 83. 209 minus 83 is 126. How much will get? 126. Right now. And what is the actual mass of the crystal? This is the actual mass of the crystal. Again, we can write the binding energy of this given nucleus in terms of atomic mass rate. How to write? For the binding energy of this nucleus, that is this man. How to write? ZMP plus A minus Z into MN minus of what by capital M. What is capital M here? Capital M indicates mass of the crystal, actual mass of the crystal. So, this is what B will take, option B will take. Right? Into 1 AMU. 1 AMU can be written into 1 U, doesn't matter. Right? Put all these values. Z mean this value, A minus Z mean this value. And MB is the mass of the proton, MN is the mass of the neutron, capital M is what? Actual mass of this crystal. By taking all this very short binding energy Z, Z is how much? That is 83. Mass of proton 1.007825 plus actual mass of plus A minus Z 126 into how much? Mass of neutron 1.008665 minus actual mass. Actual mass of how much? 208.98. How much? 208.80 into 1 AMU into 1 AMU. Actually, ZMP plus A minus Z into MN minus capital M into the mass effect of this is that. So, how to calculate the mass effect here? The mass effect that is equal to 1.760. This mass effect binding energy. How much it is? Mass effect means 83 into 1.007825 plus 26 into this value. Minus this value. So by calculating all these values, we will get the mass effect 1.760. 1.760887. Into 1 AMU into 1 U. 1 U value is how much? 1 U value is equal to 931 megaelectron. So, by multiplying 1.760887 into 931 megaelectron volt, we will get how much energy? The energy is equal to 1640. This is equal to 1640.26 megaelectron. This is what? Binding energy of the bismuth. But again, you need binding energy per nucleon. I need a binding energy per nucleon. Binding energy in this value? 1640.26 divided by mass number. What is the mass number of the bismuth? 209. 209. Then how much will you get the value? We will get 8.7848. But you are in this value. 7.848 megaelectron volt. This what? Binding energy per nucleon of the bismuth. Here two nucleons are given. One is the iron and second one is the bismuth. This is binding energy per nucleon or binding energy of the iron. And this indicates the binding energy of the bismuth. So let us see for a few seconds. So further we'll see one more problem. The problem number 3 is the given mass of coil is 3 gram. Calculate the nuclear energy required to separate protons and neutrons from each other. Assume that the coil is made up of copper and given values are there. Mass of the copper is given, mass of the proton is given, and mass of the neutron. Similarly, atomic number of the copper and number of neutrons in the copper. It's me. Here, 3 gram of carbon is given. 3 gram of copper is given. In the 3 gram of copper, how much energy is required to separate the nucleons from each other? Here, what is given? Calculate the nuclear energy required to separate the protons and neutrons from each other. To separate the protons and neutrons from the nucleus, that energy we are calling binding energy. Directly, how much binding energy required to separate the all the nucleus from each atom in an 3 gram of carbon. So let us solve this. See here, in this mineral 3 gram is given. Mass how much given? The mass equal to 3 gram is given. Mass of the copper is 3 gram. In 3 gram of copper, how many atoms are present? That we need to actually calculate first. In this gram of the mass, how many number of atoms are present? The number of atoms present that can be calculated. The number of atoms can be calculated. Avogadro number into number of gram. Number of gram divided by molecular mass. Molecular mass. Right. Avogadro number is constant. That value is 6.023 into 10 to the 23. That is constant. How it is? Number of atoms in 3 gram. Avogadro number 6.023 into 10 to the 23. Number of gram. How much number of gram? 3 gram is divided by molecular mass. What is the molecular mass of the copper? 16 is the molecular mass of the copper. Then the number of atoms in 3 gram of copper. The number of atoms in 3 gram of copper is 2.86. 2.86 into 10 to the 23. I mean, 3 gram of the copper, this much number of atoms are present. Here, first of all, for one atom, how much binding energy is required, that we need to calculate. What it is? For one atom, how much binding energy required? Binding energy to separate the protons and neutrons from each other. How much energy required? Then after we will calculate, for this much number of atoms, how much energy required? That will calculate. Shall we go? The binding energy for one atom can be given in terms of atomic mass. What it is? ZMP. ZMP plus A minus Z into MN. Minus of capital M. This is mass effect. Into 1 AMU. In terms of atomic mass unit, the binding energy for 1 atom. Then let us calculate. Here Z is given. Sorry, Z is given here. Z is how much? 29 is given. A minus Z is 34 is given. So let us put all these values. Mass of proton given, mass of neutron given, actual mass of the nucleus is given, and if you know 1 AM equal to 931 mega electron volt, shall you go? Z. Z mean how much? 29 into mass of proton. 1.00 how much? 1.007825 plus A minus Z. What is A minus Z? 34 is the number of neutrons. Into mass of neutron 1.008665 minus actual mass of the nucleus. What is the actual mass of the nucleus? 62.92. 62.92 9260U. This is what mass effect. Into 1 AMU. What is 1 AMU? 1 AMU equal to 931 mega electron volt. This value is nothing but mass effect. This value is the mass effect. So, if I calculate all these values, we will get the mass effect. The mass effect is 0.591 0.591 0.591 93. This mass effect into 1 helium you how much? 931 mega electron volt. So multiply this value. So we get binding energy. What is binding energy? Binding energy is 551.387. Binding energy will get the binding energy equal to 551.387 mega electron volt. 378 mega electron volt. This is what energy required to separate the nucleons from the nucleus for one atom. But in 3 gram of copper, how many number of atoms are present? This much number of atoms are present. That is calculated. 2.86 into 10 to the power 23. Then the total energy required for 3 gram of copper, how to give? Energy for 1 atom into number of atoms present in 3 gram of copper. Actually, this is energy required for 1 atom. Then for 3 gram, how many number of atoms are contained? This much number of atoms are contained. Put this value. E dash equal to how much? E, this value. 551.378 number of atoms. How much number of atoms? 2.86 into 10 to the power. In all these values, we will get that 1.6 into 10 to the power 25. E dash equal to 1 point. How much? 1.6 into 10 to the power 25 mega electron volt. 25 mega electron volt. To separate all the nucleons, all the nucleons mean all the protons and neutrons from 3 gram of copper, this much amount of energy is released. This is what? The numerical number. Okay. So let us see this problem for a few seconds. So let's start the next problem. Problem number 4. A radioactive isotope has a half-life of 3 years. A radioactive isotope has a half-life of 3 years. How long will it take the activity to reduce to 3.125% and 1% of original? What is given? A radioactive isotope is available. For it, the half-life is 3 years. Half-life is 3 years. To disintegrate 3.125% of original value. To disintegrate 3.125% of original value and 1% of original value. How much time is required? What it is? To disintegrate 3.125% of original value and 1% of original value. So, we will see separately. In option A, what is given? To disintegrate 3.125% of original value, how much time is required? See here, the time required can be calculated. The number of half-lives of radioactive substance into half-life. What is n? Number of half-lives of radioactive substance in the half-life. Into 1 half-life. To reduce 3.125% of original value. N is what? Original. N not is what? Original value. To reduce this much of value. I need this value. Students, we calculated somewhere. That is number of atoms left after n half-lives in our class. Number of atoms left after n half-lives. That is n divided by n naught.
equal to how much? 1 by 2 raised to n value. Right? This is R. How are at this value? N equal to what? N naught. 1 by 2 raised to how much? That is n value. Right? Now? So let us call it. Let us call it as equation number 1. What is given? N equal to N 3.125% of original value. This value. So this percent can be converted into value. In what way? Shall I take N equal to how much? N naught percent 3.125 divided by 2% or how to write this value? This value N equal to how much? N naught into 1 divided by 32. 3.125 divided by 100 divided by 1 by 32. How do I think N equal to N naught 1 by 2 raised to 5. 1 by 2 raised to 5. 1 by 2 raised to 5. Right? Shall we calculate? Shall we call this equation number 2? Correct. Here number of atoms are there. N equal to N naught 1 by 2 raised to N value. And we got N equal to N naught 1 by 2 raised to N value. Just a minute, equation 192. What will get? If we compare equation 192, what will get directly here? See here. N naught 1 by 2 raised to 5 equal to N naught 1 by 2 raised to N value. Right? This N naught, N naught will cancel. And N can replace. N can replace by how much? N can be replaced by 5. Right? How to calculate the time taken to disintegrate 3.25% of original value? This time. That is T equal to how much N? For you into how much? 1/2. To disintegrate of 3.125% of original value, we need this much of time. That is after 5 rise, it disintegrate 3.125% of a original value. This is option 1. So in the option B, how to calculate? See here. In option B, what it is? 1% of original value. 1% of original value. Again, we know that number of atoms left after n clockwise. What we know? N equal to how much? N naught. Into how much? 1 by 2 raised to n value shall come. In this problem, we are calling this equation only. But here, how much it is reduced? It is reduced 1% of original value. 1% of original. This 1% can be written. 1% can be written n naught divided by how much? That is 100. 1 by 100, that is 1%. Into that is 1. Right? Or directly, n naught by 100 value. N naught by 100. 1 by 1% means 1 by 100. So directly, shall we put this value? N equal to n naught divided by 100. Shall we call this equation 4? Just compare equation 2 and the equation 3 and 4. What will you get? See here. N naught 1 by 2 raised to n. Equal to how much? N naught divided by? N naught divided by 100. So if we simplify this value, how to get? See here, what is remaining here? N naught, N naught get cancelled. 1 by 2 raised to N equal to how much? That is 1 by 100. 1 by 100 or 2 raised to N equal to how much? That will be 100. Take a log on both sides. How it is log on both sides? See here. Log to the base of 2 raised to n equal to how much? Log to the base of 10 of 100. Right? So this is for log to the base m raised to n. Shall we simplify? N into log to the base e of 2 equal to log to the base 10 of not e and 10 log to the base 10 of 10 of 100 right n to get up say log to the base of 10 of 2.3010 log to the base of 10 of 100 then what is n n equal to 2 divided by 0.3010 then what value you get 6.64 how much it is we calculate 6.6445 equal to 6.6445 again then how to calculate the time time equals to when you need to be half then is how much this value time t equal to again 6.6445 into to reduce 1% of that original value this much time is taken so this is for option 1 and this is for option B so option B is thank you